I love mornings like this. Marcus, you've invited me out onto site. What am I here to see?
So the customer's had a recent consumer unit change, Gaz. One of them lovely Hager boards you've seen at the Electro you loved.
What, those ones with the Type 2 SPD
and
built
the Type in? A RCDs.
Oh, fantastic. So we're going to have a look at that consumer's unit, but you've also said to me on the way over, there is something else you want to bring up in this presentation.
Yeah, so I want to show you in regards to testing the RCDs and maybe some issues you might have on site with testing the Hager 61008 RCDs.
Okay, so there's something in there that all electricians need to be made aware of when testing those A-type RCCBs.
100%, and we can see how we can get around that with the mega MFT that I have.
Okay, so first of all, let's have a look at the consumer unit, and then let's look at those issues that we could have and how to solve them on testing those RCCBs.
It's wonderful from my point of view, Marcus, to see one of these fitted. We absolutely loved them at the Elect Show. Me and Joe shot a video on these. Can you show us some of the key points again with inside the consumer unit?
Yeah, of course, Gaz. Just be aware, when I lift up the lid, the electrical contractor is still on site and in the process of labelling up the consumer unit. I've got to see him putting some LED down lights throughout the ground floor of the dwelling.
Okay.
So as you see, we've got stickers like the SPD stickers still to go in. We've got obviously all of our circuits individually labelled.
Just remind us, what type of SPD is it?
So we've got a Type 2 surge protective device and that is in parallel with the main switch.
The RCCBs are what type?
So we've got two Type A RCCBs rated at 100 amps and 30 milliamps for additional protection.
That's wonderful. Let's cut away and have a look at the testing now, because you said there were some issues when testing those RCCBs.
Yes, there was.
So Marcus, all loads are off and we're plugged into one of the socket outlets. Can you set up the Mega MFT in order to carry out the RCD test for me, please?
Yeah, so we're gonna first of all set it to half times I delta M.
Okay.
And set it to 30 milliamps as it's offering additional protection.
Okay.
Now at the minute it's actually set to the AC waveform for an AC RCD. We're actually going to switch that now to a Type A RCD.
Okay, so scrolling through.
Yep. So now you can see that the waveforms have changed.
Okay, and we've picked that up in a previous video presentation that you shot with Lee.
With Lee, yeah.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. So what do we expect to happen now when we press the test button?
It's not going to trip.
Well, let's see that then.
Just what we want.
Okay, I can confirm the circuit's still on. We're going to rotate it around to now 180 degrees.
We are, yeah, both sides of the cycle. Again, shouldn't trip.
Okay, so we're all good so far.
Yeah.
Okay.
Now we're going to test it at 1 times I delta M.
We've gone back to 0 degrees.
Yeah.
We're still on A type.
We are. 103 milliseconds.
Whew. Wow, I've never seen numbers that big before.
Nope. Still acceptable, however, still on the high side.
Okay, but yeah, it's well within the 300 except. I think that's probably just going to be a psychological change in thinking that we're not going to see very, very small numbers. We're now going to see maybe higher numbers than these A-type RCDs.
Yeah.
Okay, so it's well under the 300 milliseconds acceptable. You're changing the angle again.
Yeah. Again, 105 milliseconds.
Okay. Right, okay. That's, again, a large number, but well within the 300 milliseconds acceptable. This is where you had a few issues now, I think you'll find.
Yeah, so originally, hopefully the value will be the same. However, when we tested at 5 times I delta N, so we was putting 150 milliamps into the RCD.
Okay.
It actually tripped at exactly 40.0 milliseconds.
Wow, right at the maximum allowed.
Yeah.
Okay, let's see what we get this time. This RCD has been obviously warmed up a few times.
So even though it has come slightly down, it is still
right at the point where you're thinking it's still acceptable because it's under 40 milliseconds.
Yes, it is.
Okay, at 37.7 milliseconds. So we're going to go again. We're going to change the angle over again. So we go once again.
The other side of the cycle.
And that's slightly less at 32.4 milliseconds.
It's still what you're not conventionally used to seeing, though, is it?
I'm used to seeing 9 and 8 milliseconds.
Yeah.
So what we did was, we went away, didn't we, Marcus?
We did, yeah.
And we had a look at the literature online from Hager. Okay then, Marcus. So now we can see that updated literature online from Hager's suggesting that we now need to test this actually not at 150 milliamps. What we're going to test it out?
Yeah, so now, according to the document, it's 250 milliamps. Now, BSEN 61008 allows manufacturers to choose their test parameters, and these Type A RCDs by Hager are actually rated at 250 milliamps as opposed to 150 milliamps for 40 milliseconds disconnection time.
as we've just got it to disconnect within the maximums as we've just tested, yep. I've cleared it with Mega, and they say that's totally acceptable.
Yes,
but
it
what
is,
we've
yeah.
just done, carried out the test as we normally would,
yep.
is come within the parameters required under yep. 300 and under 40 milliseconds. Yep. We're probably not going to do anything else. We've found that industry's gone out, done the testing at five times, and it's gone over
a lot of failures, yeah.
And they're sending yeah. the products back?
They are, yeah, when there's not actually a need to.
We just need to work out how we can pass 250 milliamps through the RCD. Do you know how yep. to do that with the Mega MFT?
Yes, I do, yeah.
Okay, let's set it up to pass actually now 250 rather than 150 through it.
So on this Mega MFT, we're going to go to the variable setting on the RCD. And what this allows us to do is allows us to choose what milliamps we're actually putting through the RCD.
Okay.
So I've got it set to 50 milliamps.
How did you do that? Can you just show yep. me?
Yeah. So the arrows there, when you see these two up and down arrows,
yep.
there's the corresponding arrows on the test buttons.
Okay.
This allows you to increase the value.
Oh, right, okay.
And decrease the value.
So we're going to set that to 50, but I thought we were going to pass 250 milliamps through it.
We're going to do 50 milliamps at times 5.
Okay, that makes sense.
Again, so recommended by Hager on there.
So, yeah, we've got the 5 times here. 5 times 50 is the 250 milliamps.
Is, yeah.
And that's what's recommended in order yeah. to test it when we're doing the 5 times test for this type of Hager RCD.
It is, yes.
Let's do the test and see what we get this time. Oh, that's a little bit more like it, 19.3. Yeah. So that's now doing what the manufacturers require us to do, which is to pass the 250 milliamps through the RCD rather than the conventional 150.
Yeah. Do it on both sides of the cycle again.
Okay, and we got 19.3. So what we're really saying is that this is a fallback test. If we didn't work on a conventional 3
yes.
test, that we can up it to 5 times 50 being the 250.
Yeah, because it's not actually a recognised test practice as of yet in the United Kingdom.
Okay, thank you. So Marcus, let's clarify what's gone on today. We've tested our RCCB from Hager,
yeah.
our Type A.
Type A, yeah.
And we tested it at half, 1 and 5,
yeah.
and we found all those readings are acceptable.
They were, yeah.
However, people in industry have been testing these, and even yourself the first time round.
The first time, yeah.
You got exactly 40 milliseconds at 5 times, which
yeah.
obviously flagged this
yeah.
up. That we're now saying, after looking at the website that Hager produced with additional information about
yep.
testing their RCDs, is that we should go where it doesn't pass a 5 time test at 150 milliamps. We're going to pass what through it?
250 milliamps, and that's 50 milliamps times 5, like you've seen earlier in the video.
Okay, and then we're confirming through that one
yep.
that it will disconnect within the 40 milliseconds.
It is, yeah.
Is there anything in BS7671 to support this?
Yeah, so the 18th edition is actually allowed for this under Regulation 643.8.
Okay.
And that states that the effectiveness of the RCD is deemed to be verified when it's tested at equal to or higher than 5 times its rated residual current.
Ooh, okay, so a little bit supporting them, that's good.
Yeah.
So Hager have put a document out to support it.
They have, yeah.
We've now cleared it up that
yeah.
people are out there in industry fitting the boards that Gaz loves, Joe
yeah,
loves
yeah,
and
yeah.
you love.
Yeah.
But however, we're having issues at the 5 times test.
Yeah.
Hopefully this video presentation has cleared up how we can overcome that by testing
yeah.
it at 250
Yeah, and it's obviously always important now to just check with the manufacturers again. Depending on the manufacturer, it might be slightly different. So.
Yeah, look at the instructions,
yeah.
follow the data.
Yeah,
okay. So, Marcus,
yeah.
what are we going to say?
Well, I know.
Here we go.
I'm good at it.
We hope this video has been some help.